60s.
60s?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with 71.
All right, today we're checking out the Pat Travers Band. We're listening to the song Boom Boom. Let's get into it.
Got some like rockabilly to it.
Rock and roll.
Yeah.
Okay, rockabilly swing dancing music.
Yeah.
Or square dancing. I don't know the difference. One of those. Where like a bunch of people like, are lined up and they're
where
doing
you twist
all this. Yeah.
And you kick your feet.
Yeah.
I'm just like imagining a club in the 70s. Everybody's lit. Everybody's real, you know, boozed up. And then they're like, boom, boom, boom. And then he shuts all the lights in the building off. And then they like drop to the floor and everybody's like, out go the lights. And then the lights come back on. Everybody's like, yeah. They're like dancing again.
70s?
70s. It's my guess. It can be.
See,
80s
I was
or
thinking
90s.
I was thinking 60s, but maybe 70s
right,
based
but
on
not
the cover.
White old enough for 60s.
Yeah, maybe not.
Right? It's got to be 70s.
We'll be right back.
like, you know that song that's like, one for the money, two for the show.
Yes.
Something like that?
Yeah, yeah, I've definitely heard
rock
that.
Around the clock. Maybe some, I don't know, something like that.
Something like that, yeah, yeah.
I feel like it was like that inspiration with a little heavier guitar. You know what I mean? Same vibe, but a little
same
more.
Same playlist. Yeah. Same dance party.
A little more. Same dance party.
Were those guitars distorted? Like, how did they get that sound?
They had to be. I don't know.
When did the guitar distortion become a thing? That would give us a clue on when the song came out.
Definitely the 60s or before.
Oh, Peter Frampton. It's been around for a very, long, very, very long time.
It had to be.
60s.
60s?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with 71. Yeah.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't.